Meeting with GCOM commissioners yielded no results for the delivery of elections. Local and international pressure mounts on government to respect the constitution and call general elections. Private sector commission urges government to respect constitution and call elections. And in sport, Dave Cameron criticizes ICC's crippling decision to ban Jason Holder from the third test against England. These and more right now in this our Tuesday, February 5, 2019 edition of News Update. Good evening, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thanks for joining us. Commissioners today again left disappointed after another meeting at the GAN Elections Commission yielded no results for the delivery of elections. Commissioners of the GAN Elections Commission today came out puzzled as another meeting yielded no results on the state of readiness for the delivery of elections. While the Operations Subcommittee submitted the timeframes with complemented work plans for the consideration of all elections, there was no concrete decision at the meeting. The People's Progressive Party nominated commissioners suspect there might be a deliberate attempt to delay the conduct of the 90-day election as is constitutionally required.
The chairman thinks that he's running a courtroom and that he doesn't have a commission in which his actions and the decisions he has to make has to flow from the considerations of the commissioners. And this is very unfortunate. But as I said, whatever is going on now has serious portents for the future and for how we go forward in Guyana.
The chief elections officer, Keith Lowenfield, told reporters that there might be need for a claims and objection exercise. This process is expected to take a total of 28 days, 21 days for claims and 7 for objections. July has been proposed as the earliest timeline for the holding of elections. The voters list from the November local government election will expire on April 30. This is a cause for concern as elections are to be held in 90 days, as is constitutionally required with the passage of the December 21 opposition-sponsored confidence motion.
Ours is to stay at a particular state of readiness. All that we can do outside of a specific decision of the commission. For us to, and you know 161 better than I do, Article 161, the commission shall be responsible for the conduct of elections, general and regional, local government, and the conduct of registration. Each of those subsets require an order from the commission. The commission will give the secretariat, well, the order will be published and gazetted, and then we proceed with the operations at the secretariat, as I did say yesterday.
A number of meetings among the commissioners have ended in a stalemate as they failed to meet a consensus on a time frame for the holding of election. Today, the Ethnic Relations Commission met with opposition leader Bart Jagdeo, where the chairman of that commission, Dr. John Smith, confirmed that the two will be working closely to disband ethnic tensions.
Dr. Jagdeo promised to work with us to ensure that our harmony themes get a lot of traction, so people get to know exactly what they can do and what they cannot do, especially the negative side of reporting and dealing with the political scenario this time.
Meanwhile, Jagdeo mentioned that the rhetoric of Public Health Minister Volda Lawrence must be condemned, as she spoke of giving jobs to the PNC supporters, a predominantly Afro-Guyanese party.
I spoke about Volda Lawrence's partisan comments, and that should be been condemned almost immediately. And so we expect the ERC to do more in this regard against all of those people who are online and in the papers, especially in the Chronicle, who are peddling disharmony among our people by spreading rumors.
The opposition leader made it clear that any attempt to incite racism will be reported to the ERC that now has an investigative arm.
We'll be right back. Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Secure your property, secure your life. Get the best security service from us at KGM Security Services Incorporated. Highly trained armed and unarmed officers at affordable rates. We offer armed mobile patrols, personal security, cash escort, alarm monitoring, quick response units. Also, rental of executive vehicles with armed guards. 74 Axora Avenue, Belair Park, Georgetown. Contact us on 663-3227, 699-0084 or 654-1800. KGM Security Services Incorporated. We are your source for security.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
For the best in truck spares, Daff and Cummings, it's A1 Auto Value New Road Freedom Hoop on the west side. Check them out today for seals, alternators, filters, air valves, pistons and rings, air dryers, shocks, bearings, and a whole lot more. Parts and accessories for cars and minibuses. Call today on 254-0890. 64 New Road Freedom Hoop on the west coast of Demerara. A1 Auto Value. Performance without compromise.
Opposition People's Progressive Party has staged a peaceful protest a short distance from the headquarters of the Ghana Elections Commission, demanding that there be respect for the Constitution and general elections must be held within the constitutionally mandated timeline of March 19.
Who must respect the Constitution?
G-Con!
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 What do you want?
Election!
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 What do you want?
That was a scene a corner away from the Ghana Elections Commission as the People's Progressive Party ups pressure on the government to hold early elections. Protesters were prohibited from staging a demonstration in front of the commission as officers barred entry between Barrack and Common Streets. The confidence motion was declared validly passed on December 21, 2018 by Chief Justice Roxon George Wiltshire. This means the president and cabinet would have to resign and elections must be held by March 19, 2019. But the president refused to have the cabinet resigned and is bent on remaining in office until the confidence resolution is being appealed.
The president over the weekend seemed to believe that none of this matter, and therefore we have to show him that we are serious about having him respect our constitution. And therefore, today you see a tiny expression of this, and it will grow if the government continues to violate the constitution.
Jagdeo made it categorically clear that the party will not support any action that will go beyond the 90 days deadline. For there to be an extension of the election deadline, the government will need 2/3 of the majority votes by the National Assembly. The party will not be settling for the proposed July date for elections.
No, well, this is outrageous. What is before the commission now is to come up with a set of action that will ensure that in accordance with the Constitution, the elections are held before March 19. So I don't know where this thing about July is coming in. There is only one way that date can be extended, and we all know the opposition and government has to agree by a 2/3 majority in Parliament. Right now, court would have ruled that elections must be held by March 19.
Already, the international community is mounting pressure on the government to have the Ghana constitution be upheld. The United Nations resident coordinator, Mikiko Tanaka, and the European Union delegation have warned of the need for constitutional compliance by the government. We tell you now that the Private Sector Commission has reprimanded the government for making statements that contravenes the ruling of the High Court on the validity of the confidence motion. The PSC affirmed that the status quo cannot remain as cabinet has been dissolved, the ruling given by the Chief Justice acting.
The Private Sector Commission, PSC, has registered its concerns at the statement being made by the government after the High Court upheld the no confidence motion. Chief Justice Roxon George Wiltshire ruled that though Charan Das Prasad was not qualified to be elected as a Member of Parliament, his vote on the confidence motion was valid and the motion was validly passed. She also ruled that there was an automaticity of the resignation of cabinet from the time the motion was declared passed by the Speaker of the National Assembly. Justice George Wiltshire also denied the application of the Attorney General to allow the status quo to remain. Regardless of her ruling, the government claims until the matter is concluded at the highest court of appeal, the status quo remains and the business of the government continues as usual. It is against this backdrop that the Private Sector Commission decided to discipline the government. The PSC affirmed that the status quo cannot remain and the government cannot continue to operate in the same manner as prior to December 21. The PSC says the reckless statements of the government could lead Ghana into a situation of grave instability. As such, the Commission said it expects the President and his government to respect and honor the decision of the Chief Justice and to proceed to have elections held no later than March 21 as required by Article 106(7) of the Constitution. Additionally, the PSC welcomed the statement by United Nations Resident Representative Mikiko Tanaka, calling upon the government to demonstrate its integrity and respect of Ghana's constitution and the judiciary. The Commission also welcomed the statement by the delegation of the European Union in Ghana, calling on all concerned parties and stakeholders to uphold the constitution. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
The Venezuelans that are alleged to have migrated to Guyana and been squatting on the east coast of Demerara shoreline are actually Guyanese who were living in Venezuela for a number of years. They have returned due to the country's economic hardship and are living in unacceptable conditions. Godfrey Brooms met with them and heard their stories.
The National Multisectoral Coordinating Committee, set up to cater to the needs of Venezuelans fleeing their crisis-hit country, reported that Venezuelans are suspected to have established settlements along the Nonpareil shoreline. However, When this newscast went to the location, the persons were speaking both Spanish and English and claimed to be Guyanese who migrated to Venezuela a number of years ago. But due to the economic and political crisis in that country, they returned to their homeland seeking a better life. Sakram Kemraj tells his story how he moved from being wealthy in Venezuela to living in a shack in Guyana.
Are you working?
Well, right now I'm working. I get a little work at a security company, but not a part-time something work.
Is it enough, the money?
No, not enough. The money can't do. The cost of living in Guyana is extra high. Money can't do. Instead, we go forward, we go backward. We used to use gas stove and buy gas. Gas raised, we can't afford gas stove now. We're going and buy Kero raised, so now we're going on fireside now. We can't do nothing more, brother. That is the only system we're handling right now. Well, I was a jack of all trades, carpenter, tailoring, sandblasting, spray painter, construction, any field you put me, I got a jack of all trades. I had workshop and I had a workshop over there, carpentry, and I had a shop buying, selling goods and all kinds of different things.
Then you had to shut down.
And then I had to shut down because of the inflation, the country, money devaluating, the government and the crisis, everything just coming down. I used to make furniture and support stores over there and all kinds of things. Was wealthy off, don't have to go nowhere and work with nobody. I had like about 10 years, don't work for nobody, you know? So I just come back here now and everything just thing. I had to go and start rock from zero again. We know it's the government reserve and them thing, right? So we willing to pay for our slot when we work and get some money. If the government could assist me with that, we will be grateful, right? But for now, as we on this land here, we need a little assistance and a little help concerning light and water.
Another woman who moved her family back to Guyana is also pleading with the government to assist in any way possible.
Well, that what need a help is for my children then, because I have 5 children right now. I'm going to get them in school yet because my husband working very little bit money. And we got to pay for change over the paper then because they're banned in Venezuela.
Currently, there is no drinking water and the shacks they live in are at the mercy of the weather. There are approximately 27 Guyanese that returned and are living in this squatting area.
Reporting for MTV News Update from Qualijin squatting area, Godfrey Brooms.
You're watching News Update. More news after the break. Stay with us.
Sankar's Auto Works, exceptional service.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 622-6943.
millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Are you invited to that important event but don't know what to wear, or frustrated you're wearing the same dress as everyone else? You crave for this exclusive look? Then do just that with dresses from Exclusive Dresses to Impress. Visit Exclusive Dresses to Impress at Giveland Mall. Contact number 657-0166.
Welcome back, your Soul News Update. The University of Ghana was today evacuated and classes were cancelled the following a bomb scare.
Vice-Chancellor Ivlo Griffith told this newscast that all students and teachers were excused for the day as the police and fire department, along with a team from the university's facilities management, assessed the buildings.
Simply, we received from the police an indication that a bomb threat was called in, and therefore they activated their protocol, which means bringing a canine unit, and we're doing a building-by-building sweep. I've sent all the students home, all the staff home, until we establish full security of our buildings.
However, Griffith said he expects classes to resume as per normal tomorrow once approval is given from the police. He further stated that it is disappointing that the university has to endure such a situation when they are only 3 weeks into the new semester. The chancellor noted that it is no consolation to say that other academic entities have been experiencing similar issues, but the university aims to protect all students and staff going forward. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
A fruit vendor has been arrested after police swooped down on his home and conducted a search where they found a quantity of marijuana. iNews reports that Fitzroy Gibson of North Rumfeld, Georgia, was arrested with several parcels of the illegal drugs found hidden in a microwave, while another set was discovered buried in the backyard. Gibson is present being processed for court. As was promised, Attorney General Basil Williams has filed appeals into two of the three confidence motion cases he lost in the High Court. His appeal application claims that the Chief Justice erred in her decisions, and he wants the appeal court to grant two orders setting aside the rulings.
In two documents seen by this newscast, the Attorney General is appealing the decisions given in the matters Ram versus the AG and the AG versus Dr. Barton Scotland and Barra Jagdeo. The Attorney General Basil Williams claims the Chief Justice Roxanne George Wilshire erred and misdirected herself in law when she ruled that the motion of no confidence was validly passed, 33-32, as the requisite majority of all the elected members of the National Assembly. He also claims that the Chief Justice blundered when she ruled that the Speaker's ruling that the motion of no confidence was passed in accordance with Article 1066 and requires that the Cabinet shall resign on December 21, 2018. Williams says Justice George Wilshire's decisions were unreasonable and cannot be supported. As such, he is seeking two orders to set aside the decisions the Chief Justice made on January 31, 2019. He also affirmed that further grounds of appeal will be made when the rulings of the Chief Justice becomes available. The government has vowed to take the matter to the highest court, the Caribbean Court of Justice, if the appeal court's decision is unfavorable. The government also claimed that the status quo remains and it will be business as usual, despite the Chief Justice ruled that cabinet has been dissolved and refused to grant a stay of execution for the status quo to be maintained. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
A miner was on Thursday last buried alive after a mining pit caved in at Omanak village, Upper Mazaruni River. The dead man has been identified as 50-year-old Timothy Hunt of Jawala Reservation, Upper Mazaruni River. Based on information received, Hunt, along with others, were working in a pit when a wall suddenly collapsed, covering him in the process. The other workers reportedly attempted to get him from under the debris, but by the time they did, it was too late. His body was taken to the Environmental Health Center, where he was pronounced dead on arrival. A postmortem is expected to be conducted shortly. Police are continuing their investigation into the death of the miner. President David Granger today departed Guyana for the Republic of Cuba to continue another round of chemotherapy treatment after he was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin lymphoma, a form of cancer. Here are the details. President David Granger today departed Guyana for the Republic of Cuba for another round of medical evaluation. The president has been diagnosed with non-Hodgkin lymphoma, a form of cancer. He's expected to make several visits to Cuba as he has a draft schedule for treatment which will run until May 2019. Due to his continued treatment, the president's public engagements have been reduced based on advice from his medical team. The Cuban team assigned to the president said that the head of state's progress has exceeded its expectation. During his visits to Cuba, the president met with Cuban Foreign Minister Bruno Rodriguez, President Miguel Díaz-Canel Bermúdez, and Forest Vice President Salvador Valdés Misa. It was during that time the two parties deepened talks and bilateral relations to include cooperation in the sugar industry and expanding the export market. Professional training in English language in partnership between the University of Guyana and the University of Cuba was also on the agenda.
Deputy City Engineer Keston Boston has revealed that most drainage pumps in the municipality are inoperable, and as such, the municipality is depending on low tides for drainage. Here is Celine Griffith.
With the rainy season approaching, flooding is likely to occur. Deputy City Engineer Keston Boston stated that the accumulation of garbage is one of the major contributors to flooding in the city. He further explained that measures are in place to dispose of the excess water, but most of the pumps, which are a vital part of the process, are down.
When the water recedes, we have the sluice doors that would open and drain out the excess water within the city. Yes, so that the pumps are down.
However, Boston optimistically stated that within the next 3 weeks, two more pumps should be up and running, namely along Princess Street and the Kingston area. He reassured that daily efforts are being made to ensure drains and alleyways are clean in an effort to keep water levels low and prevent flooding. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
We now join Kipani Jordan with today's tips for healthy living.
A sore throat is often the first sign of a cold and may get better after a day or two. Other cold symptoms, such as a runny nose and congestion, may follow the sore throat. The primary symptom of tonsillitis is a moderate to severe sore throat lasting longer than 2 days and involves inflammation of the tonsils. Other symptoms of tonsillitis may include difficult or painful swallowing, swollen or tender glands, lymph nodes on the sides of the neck, bad breath, fever and chills, tiredness and headache, stomach upset or pain, enlarged or reddened tonsils with spots of white or yellow pus, mouth breathing, noisy breathing, and or snoring due to enlarged tonsils blocking the airways. Symptoms of tonsillitis may resolve after 3 to 4 days but may last up to 2 weeks even with treatment. Avoiding close contact with people who have tonsillitis is advisable to prevent passing of the infection. Children and other family members should keep far away from people with tonsillitis as much as possible. Hygiene measures should also be used to prevent the spread of an infection, which may include regular and thorough washing and drying of hands, using a tissue to cover coughs and sneezes, frequent and thorough washing and drying of hands, not sharing foods, liquids, or eating utensils or drinking vessels, frequent cleaning of surfaces, particularly in the kitchen and bathroom. Treatment of viral tonsillitis primarily involves rest, recovery, and symptom relief. It is also important to drink plenty of fluids and have regular meals. Soft foods and smoothies are best. If bacterial infection is confirmed by throat culture, antibiotics will be prescribed to prevent complications, particularly rheumatic fever and kidney disease. It is important to take the full course of antibiotics as prescribed to prevent the infection returning and to reduce the likelihood of developing rheumatic fever or kidney disease. Gargling salt water half teaspoon of salt to a cup of warm water, may provide some symptom relief, as may sucking on hard sweets or throat lozenges containing ingredients that are cooling, anesthetic, antiseptic, and anti-inflammatory. Corticosteroids such as dexatasone or prednisone may be prescribed to reduce inflammation and swelling, particularly when it is making swallowing and breathing difficult.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sports update and more. Stay with us.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague. Ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet, presenting Coliomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh. It's the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coliomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coliomac. Only at SlimJet, City Mall, second floor, or in New Amsterdam, 22 Asylum and Main Road, Berbice.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step three, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step four, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex toilet tissue, super soft and super durable, guaranteed.
Your one-stop decor solution for gala dinners, weddings, birthdays, cocktail functions, backdrops, props, and more, check out Exclusive Decor Design, Ground Floor, City Mall. We have a wide variety to suit your stylish seating and table decor, exclusive centerpieces, colorful maro, and much more. Working with a small budget? No problem. We've got you covered. Call 225-4434 or 657-0166. We listen, we create, you enjoy.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sale service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome to MTV's Sports Update. Narayan Ramdhani, Guyana's number one badminton player, copped a second place finish in the Alberta College Athletic Conference Intercollege University Tournament at Urbs College, Alberta, Canada. According to the newsroom, this is the third consecutive final for Ramdhani in the four-leg tournament after he won in November and took second spot in early January. The final leg of the tournament will take place on February 17 at Concordia University. The latest action in Sunday last at Odds College once again featured competitors from Ramdhani's team, the King's University Eagles, Olds College Broncos, Concordia University of Edmonton Thunder, and Northern Alberta Institute of Technology Oaks. Ramdhani, the number one seeded player in the singles competition, defeated Jeffrey Koh of NAIT 21-10, 21-17 in the quarterfinals before topping Ranella Medina of NAIT 21-15, 21-10 in the semifinals. In the final, Ramdhani lost 11-21, 10-21 to second seed Nicholas Pittman of Concordia. In the men doubles, Ramdhani teamed up with a new partner Akash Panchal, losing at the quarterfinal stage of Branson 1 and Raffle Wong of Concordia 21-18, 21-17. They eventually finished 5th overall, defeating Alex Buller and Ron Led of Odds 21-16, 21-13 and Colton Gearer and Luther Jerk 21-15, 21-16. Fast bowlers have taken giant strides in the recent test rankings with Australia's Pat Cummins and West Indies captain Jason Holder reaching their career best rankings following their dominant performances in series wins against Sri Lanka and England, respectively.
Fast bowlers have taken giant strides in the recent test rankings with Australia's Pat Cummins and West Indies captain Jason Holder reaching their career-best rankings following their dominating performances in series wins against Sri Lanka and England, respectively. While Cummins leapfrogged James Anderson to number 2 after picking 14 wickets in two tests against Sri Lanka, Holder's 5 wickets in the second test in Antigua that completed a series win against England lifted him to 6th position. Holder, who last week became the first West Indies player to become a top-ranked test all-rounder since Sir Gary Sobers in 1974, now has 778 points, the highest by any West Indies bowler since Courtney Walsh in 2001. His fast-bowling compatriots Kemar Roach and Shannon Gabriel have also moved up the charts. Roach, who was the man of the match in Antigua for his 8-4, jumped 8 places to number 12, just one behind Gabriel, who picked 5 wickets in the 2 tests to go up 1 spot. The last time West Indies had 4 fast bowlers, Courtly Ambrose, Walsh, Ian Bishop, and Kenny Benjamin, in the top 12 ranking was 1996. Australia's Michelle Starc, who was adjudged man of the match for his 10-4 in Canberra, vaulted 10 places to 15th position after the host's 366-run win against Sri Lanka. Kipani Jordan reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
Cricket West Indies president Dave Cameron has hit out at the crippling decision to ban captain Jason Holder from the third test against England. Holder has been given a one-match suspension for his side's slow over rate during their second test victory. Cameron says the rule ought to be modified. West Indies were ruled to have bowled 2 over fewer than their target number during the second test at Antigua. Holder has been a central figure in the West Indies, securing a first series win over England since 2009 and their first over any side other than Bangladesh and Zimbabwe since 2012. He was named man of the match after making an unbeaten 202 and taking 2 wickets in the 381-run win in the first test, a performance which took him to the top of the ICC rankings for test all-rounders. Holder claimed 4 for 32 to help pull England out for 132 in Antigua on Saturday before the West Indies sealed the victory with 2 days to spare. He missed the second test in New Zealand in December 2017 after being banned for a slow overweight offence. Opener Craig Brathwaite will captain West Indies in the third test, which starts in St. Lucia on Saturday. And we tell you now that Windies women's star Deandra Dutton lived up to her rank as one of the better T20 all-rounders in the world as her heroics in the 220 series against Pakistan helped the tourists snatch their first series win of 2019. Let's take a look.
With the series ending 2-1, Windies will be gunning up when the final one-day international series bowls off on February 7. One play in particular could surge to the top of the International Cricket Council ICC T20 rankings and possibly dethrone her skipper and current leader, Stephanie Taylor. The Caribbean ladies winged out to Pakistan a few days ago as they sought to rebuild the once popular cricket brand. The visitors immediately made their mark at Karachi a few days ago when they hammered a hapless-looking Pakistan team in the first T20 international played at Southend Club Ground. Windies' chances of winning the series were always in good hands, especially with the star-studded team they took to Asia. However, it was Dutton's outrageous knock of 90-0 out of half the number of balls which broke the back of the Pakistani ladies from the inception. With a mixture of sixes and fours, Dutton hammered her side to a 78-run win before returning in the second match to play her role as the key utility player. The Bajan aced the start of the chase with a crisp knock of 22 with five fours, the most by any player in the team during the innings. The fast bowler earlier stunted the home team's pursuit of a big total when she snagged the best bowling figures amongst her teammates with a 26-for-2 from her four overs. The combined strength of Dutton and company, namely Guyanese Shemaine Campbell, who won Most Valuable Player, MVP, for leading the chase with a top score of 41, helped Windies seize the series 2-0. The final match saw Pakistan outdo the visitors, but Dutton remained resolute in her gameplay. Dutton ended the three matches with 176 runs and a similar average to match from just the three innings played. The all-rounder also bagged three wickets in the series. In terms of her international rank, Dutton comes in second at the top of the list with 321 points, 32 behind Taylor, who heads the lot with 353. One mega bonus for Dutton is the absence of Taylor, who opted out of the tour to Pakistan owing to the country's history of security issues regarding cricket being staged there. Taylor was not the first player to opt out of the trip to Pakistan, and her absence, as well as that of Hayley Matthews, meant that Dutton was forced to step up and be the leader of the team in both departments. Kippenny Durden reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
Football Federation Australia has pledged over £5,000 in a bid to help return a jailed Bahrainian refugee player Hakim Al-Arabi from Thailand. Al-Arabi, who had been playing in Australia after being granted asylum there, was arrested in Thailand when he arrived with his wife on honeymoon. He is wanted in Bahrain, where he was sentenced in absentia to 10 years in jail for vandalizing a police station. The FA wants Al-Arabi returned to Australia as a matter of urgency. Al-Arabi says he is innocent and that he was tortured in Bahrain for his political opposition. On Monday, he urged a court in Bangkok not to extradite him to his home country. The court extended his detention to 60 days, during which he can file an objection against the extradition request. More news after the break. Stay with us.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Now for some news in the region. A group of Latin American countries and Canada has urged the Venezuelan military to support opposition leader Juan Guaido as interim president. In a statement, 11 of the 14 members of the Lima group called for a change of quo without the use of force and the urgent delivery of humanitarian aid. Mr. Guaido has declared himself interim president and won support from major powers, including the U.S. President Nicolas Maduro says he is a legitimate leader of Venezuela. Mr. Maduro, who has been backing a number of countries, including China and Russia, earlier warned that the country's deepening political crisis could spark a civil war. On international scene, 10 people, including a baby, have died in a fire at an 8-story building in southwestern Paris, officials say. More than 30 people, including 6 firefighters, were injured. One person is in a serious condition. 50 people were evacuated by ladders from the blaze in the upmarket 16th Arses segment. Investigators believe the fire, one of the most deadly in the French capital in years, was possibly started deliberately. Earlier, French President Emmanuel Macron said the country has woken up to tragedy and praised the fire service for their courage. Royal Langres is a residential street close to the Parc des Princes football stadium and the Roland Garros tennis venue. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 8:11. We now turn our attention to the Demer Harbour Bridge and the Borbis River Bridge schedules. That's a wrap on today's broadcast. Before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Meeting with GCOM, commissioners yielded no results for the delivery of elections. Local and international pressure mounts on government to respect the constitution and call general elections. Private sector commission urges government to respect the constitution and call elections. And in sport, Dave Cameron criticizes ICC's crippling decision to ban Jason Holder from the third test against England. Catch our rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramotar. Thank you for watching. Have a good night.